Well, it's time for the next part. We're essentially just, you know, chasing after Sheila. And in the case of this being a dumb mind stage, it's of course Burn Burning. It took her. And it's chapter 18. It's worth the halfway point of the game. But yeah. As you noticed, one thing I always notice about my style of play when it comes to Super Hour Wars or anything, I don't use UC Gundams as much. Yeah, I think the only ones I've used was the new Gundam. As you meant. Okay, that'll work, because Death Scythe and Heavy Arms and the Gundam Wing Gundams are top tier in this game. But yeah, basically, even though this isn't their Bison Well and Burn is here, it might as well, you know, conquer. So yeah, luckily these can all be killed easily. But anyways, because it's new territory, they might as well conquer it for Drake himself, which I just think is dumb. He's got the hypothesized Aeldebeth now. I think it's so good. I know it'll be hard to hit, but let's hope we can hit them. Then Duo is just reason enough. But now we're up against essentially the War Battlers and those little machines that are supposed to be the, what's called, successors to War Battlers. By the way, nothing stands a chance against Death Scythe in this game. Beam Scythe kills against me right there. Done. Sweet, we got the Disrupt Spirit Command. Gundam range. I think the sole downside of Wing Zero in this game is once again it doesn't have access to its rolling buster attack, but not well. Guess we'll have to end for now. I like Fire Emblem. We have to end the turn manually. This doesn't end well for any of them. But yeah, right now I'm fighting to stop Drake's ambition because Drake wants to conquer this new world as well. And I guess Burn is just doing this because, you know, you gotta look good in front of your boss after failing so much. So yeah. Hey, this chapter isn't really as hard as you think, like, literally, the game gives you the resources to literally own just about everything. So we got everything we need. Brokenness of this Aeldebeth. Look at how nice it looks. Yeah, I honestly do hope that it appears in the next OG game. This is just too good. I should probably, knowing this stage, and knowing Drake's forces, there will probably be reinforcements. And then we can finish them quickly. Let's just finish these guys off first. Yeah, those guys don't stand a chance against the Isle of Death, so... yeah. Oh, snap. Yeah, Shion was even surprised that there are so many orb battlers in this world. Hey, these are Drake's reinforcements. Yes, I thought, dang, if only Wing Zero had its rowing map attack, like in... it's gonna be like a situation in Z2, where, you know, you just weaken them all and then use Wing Zero to destroy them all. Oh well. They can barely damage the thing. Good, they're all moving this way. Even an aura battle can't stop actual bullets. I still question that, like the whole aura thing. I mean, it's like in how in Elgin, you never know that they're all coated with beam coats. Like Super Robot Wars 4 and any game that features Elgin shows that they're all coated in beam coats, which makes beam weaponry essentially useless against them. We never even learned that until, well, you know, you actually hit them. Then you learn, oh snap, this doesn't work. This spaceship's useless. And then I'm still thinking about the turbines, since in this game it sucks. Okay, Burn's dead. Dang, that range. Now we'll kill Sheila next. So Sheila's the one we're saving. Muzi's the one we're fighting. Nah. We can kill her next turn. Kill everybody around her first. Good thing is that Scythe has A rank. In everything. The Hyper Gem is too good. I don't understand the logic behind that. It's like it doesn't work, but it works. Makes sense. It was her first combat outing, so of course she is defeated and leaves. And there's another boss up there. Okay. And that's rely upon to get her. Believe in to get her. After all, three souls acting as one. Three hearts combined. Ultimate teamwork. side is together. All sides are done, so should be done by next turn, actually. Idiot. It's like Super Robot Wars King and Dan and Thursday all over again. Where Dan and Thursday is the best unit in the game, but they will all consistently attack Dan. The Gary being too strong. Okay, now they're all dead. Unfortunately... here they come. Wait for it. But yeah, she's going off to her kingdom, you know, the usual. We at least got the kingdom of non-support, so we're good. But now here's Goblin Tribe. Goblin Tribe Force are the main antagonists of Acro Bunch, a very mediocre series about searching for Atlantis. There's Acro Bunch. But yeah, apparently they arrived, they didn't think we were allies of Acro Bunch, and then Acro Bunch appears. Well, I honestly don't like Acro Bunch. Unlike with Mechander Robo, where I warmed up to it, and actually began to like it because it's actually pretty good, I just can't get into the characters of Acro Bunch. It is cool though, in that it's, I think, the first mech in Super Robot Wars history to have to debut with a mech that has 6 pilots. The downside is, it's trash. So it's not worth it. But yeah, they're looking for Atlantis. That's the main thing about Acro Bunch. As you notice, it's got decent range, but its attacks barely can do anything. The good thing is our best units have the movement command. Well, Axel, so we can move in and just kill them all. Get tattoos. Movement, it's amazing. I remember, I'm still not forgetting that, when I first played Super Robot Wars, when I was way younger, this was like when I was a freshman in high school, no, like, I think a sophomore. Remember, I didn't understand what the Getter was, so I always just thought to use Getter 2 because I didn't understand Getter 1. Then when I actually saw Getter Robo Armageddon, it all made sense. And thus I use the Getter, two of three of the Getter's forms, cause no offense, nobody really uses Getter 3 unless the enemy's in water, like in Super Robot Wars 4. If the enemy's not in water, they're probably not gonna use it. But regardless, 3 pilots that act as 1. It's amazing. Okay, is that what we need? The good thing is, Volca instantly has every turn that starts, he instantly recasts the money command that gives you more money upon killing enemies. hate the fact that they can support each other. The downside of this game is it doesn't show you if they can support defend or not. Only in the case of you, where it can show your options, but it won't show if they're able to or if somebody will take the hit. Okay, it's time to at least show Acrobat can do. Yeah, I think he's the first mech in Super Robot Wars history to have 6 different spear commands. Unlike later games where they nerfed that, so like, where the subpilots barely have spear commands, each pilot has all 6. As you can tell, they barely do any damage though. That's what kills it for me. They can take damage. It's like a bad Vancouver Nova. I'm sorry, that was just hilarious to me. Let's try and get more supports in. Anyways, that storyline wise, they're in here because they believe Atlantis is located around here. Nah, it's not. Or the power of Atlantis, to be exact. In the end, though, dimensional stuff is just messing up their calibrations. So it's not working out like that. I guess he wondered though, right? Yeah, as I thought, he already has it casted. So I can't do anything with that. Gotta think ahead. Cause we can use Folka to kill the other one, let's use Wufei for this. We get all the money. And as he retreats. His final slash attack should be able to weaken him at least. Yeah, you'd expect like a bigger robot to do more against a Gamelef when a Gamelef's like 8 meters tall. Oh well. It's time to finish her. Alright. Unfortunately, because the Acrobunch family is useless, they leave. So, yeah, I don't have much faith in Acrobunch. Yeah, might as well get him to close enough for SP restore. Anyways, time to head out, and while we're in Drake's forces, well, not really Drake's forces, Remy right there, Drake's daughter. He's already built an aura ship that he's gonna try and take down the kingdom of... Anyways, the kingdom of R. But, you know, we're not gonna let that happen. Thanks for watching, everybody, since this part's just about over. Till next time.